Well, good morning, everyone. It's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with a look at the U.S. stock market for Tuesday morning. In the pre-market this morning, stock index futures and commodities are currently trading right around fair value, so not a lot of excitement in the pre-market on Tuesday morning. Today is day one of a two-day Fed meeting, and so, of course, we expect the excitement to start after 2 p.m. Wednesday afternoon. Before I start any stock market analysis, I like to take a look at the VIX, and if the VIX is on a sell signal, then that is a pretty good sign that the stock market is still looking for higher prices. That is true for Monday with the Dow 30 making a new all-time high for the S&P 500. We saw a little pullback in the NASDAQ yesterday, but not in the chip sector, which continued to move higher on Monday. Now, we can split the stock market up several ways. If we look at the Wilshire 5000, which of course is not 5000 stocks anymore, new all-time high yesterday, new all-time high for the large cap stocks. But then if you break it up, mid-cap stocks trading up to previous resistance, and then small cap stocks still trailing the mid-caps, as are the micro-cap stocks. So no new highs for those. And of course, the micro caps, we look at the Zacks micro cap index to keep track of those stocks. Looking at breaking up the market by sector, we can look at the Spider sector ETFs and the consumer discretionary traded down through the lower channel line yesterday, but did not close below it. And so on Tuesday, we need to close below 89.23 to give us a new sell signal for consumer discretionaries. Consumer staples continued to move higher yesterday, as did the energy sector. Now, the energy sector made a high on Thursday, and we're looking to see if we can take that out. That high, of course, takes us back to the highs from late July. And so we are still looking for higher prices here in the energy sector. But, of course, we have to see if the market will let us do that at this time. Looking at financial services, a nice move up yesterday, gapped higher on the day. Looking at healthcare stocks, we've been treading water for the last few days. There's industrials making a new high. We saw materials continue to move higher yesterday. Little pullback in real estate, but no change in trend just yet. Technology stocks, the Spider Technology ETF moved slightly higher yesterday, making a new high for this move. And looking at the Spider Utility ETF, we've been on a sell signal for a couple of days now, and no change in trend there. Looking at some of the commodity-based ETFs that we follow, the gold miners ETF made a new low yesterday, as did the silver miners, and copper miners closed slightly higher on the day, but still no change in trend there. Looking at the bond market, the bonds have been on a sell signal for a couple of days now, new low for the 30-year bond, new low for the TLT. Junk bonds had a slight pullback yesterday, just down a penny on the day, but made a new high for this move. And emerging market bonds pulled back yesterday. We need to close on Tuesday below 116.70 to give us a new sell signal there. Looking at currencies, there's the US dollar index. It's on a buy signal right now, but no follow through to the upside. There's the euro on a sell signal, but no follow through to the downside. And there's the Canadian dollar generating a new sell signal as of Monday's close. Let's finish off by looking at commodities themselves. There's the commodity tracking ETF still on a buy signal. Crude oil still on a buy signal. No change there. Nice gap higher for natural gas on Monday. Looking up, 742 would be my next big target to the upside if we can continue higher from here. There is copper still on a sell signal. No change there. No change in trend for gold making a new low yesterday. And no change in trend for silver, with silver making a new low for this move on Monday. Okay, folks, that is all for this morning's presentation. Next time you'll hear my voice is on Wednesday morning, and at that time we'll take a closer look at the Canadian stock market.